Scorpios, what's up, Scorpio? I don't know why, I just started doing your reading and I'm already getting this feeling of like excitement, like pumped up. So while I was meditating over your cards and shuffling, I was hearing that Cardi B song, I Like It. So I was like, what's going on with Scorpios? What's going on with Scorpios in the month of June? Okay, I've seen a lot of the Six of Cups. Are you guys trying to have a new beginning with someone from your past? Are you guys traveling? Are you going to Miami? I don't know why I'm thinking Miami. I think it's because of the song. I like it like that. That song reminds me of Miami. It has such Miami vibes. But, yeah, this card is coming out a lot too. The Seven of Cups, okay, Scorp? So don't start getting caught up in your feelings again. Getting confused, not knowing what decisions to make, because you guys were going through that for a while, okay? You're moving forward, you're possibly communicating a lot of things, but I don't know, something about June feels good. I don't know, I feel like your energy, you guys feel excited. So something major is happening in June that's got you guys happy. So let's get into it for Scorpio. Let's find out what's going on for Scorpios. This will be Scorpio, Sun, Moon, and Rising. And let's see what's going on for the majority of Scorpios, okay? If this doesn't resonate with you, check your sun, moon, and rising signs to see if that resonates better. And I'm probably going to fast forward this so we can keep the video short. So let's get into it. So what is... Okay, before I can even do anything, Six of Swords. Gemini had this in their present situation too. So you could be dealing with Gemini or travel. Like I was saying, there's like travel. Either you're excited because someone's traveling to see you, or you're traveling to see someone, or you're going on vacation, or you're moving into better energy in the month of June. And I feel it. As soon as I started like meditating over Scorpio, I got really excited. I don't know why, but what's this? There it goes, the Magician, Gemini card again, right? Or you're manifesting something. You're manifesting something in the month of June. Something is coming into fruition and you're excited and happy about it. All right. This flew out. You've got the Queen of Swords and the Nine of Cups in reverse. So either this is you confronting emotional, you know, not being emotionally fulfilled, or you're dealing with, again, this air sign energy. You're dealing with an air sign who's not very happy. Could be someone from your past, someone from your future. I think you're dealing with someone who's very unhappy, or this could be your energy communicating about unhappiness or not being fulfilled. All right, Scorpios, let's see what's going on for you guys in the month of June 2018. Hangman in reverse, okay, first card out. Ooh, look at you getting out of a situation. You are getting unstuck. You are getting out of something. You were definitely in this energy of like being indecisive, needing to make a decision, not knowing how to move forward. You're out of that. All right, I think you're realizing something's not working or wasn't working, or you're getting out of a third party situation, okay? Could be with the fire sign, if not maybe an earth sign, air sign, they're all here. Okay. Could be thinking about an Aquarius, thinking about healing, you want to heal something, you want to work on something, but it involves other people to work on it as well. All right, and again, here you go with these Two of Swords, Two of Wands, Two of Pentacles, you know, decisions, subconsciously, you are torn. You're torn. Right now, I feel like either you're focused on freeing yourself, or some Scorpios, you're focused on freeing yourselves and healing. For others of you, you are acknowledging the fact that you have been stuck in a situation that doesn't work, and you want to get out of it now. Right, here's your overall energy in June. So contemplation, rest. All right, I feel like you've been through a lot. You've been through a lot, and now you're trying to really rest and rejuvenate and recover. Media environment, Seven of Pentacles. And the overall outcome is the Knight of Cups, all right? This is you guys, right? This is your energy. So this is either you moving forward, making an offer. Gemini also got this in their near future that someone was riding in. You know, this is the Knight in Shining Armor card. So either a Knight in Shining Armor is coming in for you, someone who is stuck in a situation, or you're moving towards someone. Bottom of your deck, you have the Empress in reverse. So you could be coming out of a marriage, coming out of a serious relationship, coming out of something that wasn't, like I'm saying, wasn't developing, wasn't bearing fruit. Even though in your environment, it seems like, you know, you are getting some sort of like financial compensation, but I feel like more so this is saying something is coming through for you, which is true here in your likely outcome. Nine of Wands in reverse. So I feel like you're giving up. You're giving up on something that wasn't working, all right? Maybe you haven't communicated it yet. This could also be with that air sign person, but you want to free yourself in a way. You got this eight and then the seven here. You want to free yourself. You're unsatisfied. You're dissatisfied, possibly with an earth sign. This Queen of Pentacles comes out a lot in your readings. So Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo person you're dealing with. And I feel like you are going to communicate. Or you're holding back communication. Yeah, Page of Cups. The Wheel of Fortune is here, so it's time for you to get unstuck. That's what your theme about here is, getting unstuck, getting out of a situation that you're not satisfied with. There you go. Then you end that chapter, right? You get out of it, and what's behind there? The Ten of Cups, happiness, fulfillment. It's not going to come without fights, for sure, but yeah, and then I saw that Ten of Pentacles. You're going for the ultimate happiness. And I know Scorpios, they don't settle. I feel like you guys feel like you're settling or you're in something that's not fulfilling to you and you want something more. You want something more. You were hesitant before to go after it, but now look at you. You're going for it. You're definitely going for it. All right, Scorpio, so let's start to clarify. Look what's at the bottom of your deck, right? All right, let's get into it. Let's see what's going on. You got a lot of repeating cards here at the bottom of your deck. So let's see the present situation with Hanged Man here in reverse. Why is the Hanged Man here in reverse for Scorpio? Ooh, the Tower. So something came crashing down, something that was not working. You are leaving a situation, you're coming out of a situation, or you just had some major like breakthrough realization, like something just came over you. This is strong energy, two major arcana, so it's like you had some like major awakening, something that like has shocked you into coming out of this energy of like being, you know, blindfolded and not able to see what was right in front of you. And now it's like you had like an aha moment, like, oh shit, you know, whatever I'm currently doing right now is not working for me. It's not making me happy. It's not what I want. But it's also like you don't know how to get out of it too. You know what I mean? It's like you realize now that it's time to go, but you don't really know how to get out of it. And let's see, what do I want to clarify? Let's do King of Wands in the near future, right? So what is this King of Wands energy here in the near future? Ace of Wands. So having a new beginning, I feel like you're not very confident about a new beginning. All right, so you're having like this issue with lack of confidence, okay? Like I'm saying, you don't know how to move forward, but you know that where you are right now is not where you want to be. Right? But you're lacking the confidence to either make a decision or to, you know, to go for a new start. That's why I feel like your energy is here, like contemplation again, rest, thoughts. You're really thinking about like, you're meditating a little bit, like, do I want to go for this? How can I go for this? I see you going for it though. I see you going for it. Let's see in your mind, on your thoughts, you have the Star card in reverse. So there's things on your mind that you haven't healed yet. What's the Star in reverse on the mind of Scorpio? Yeah, there's a lot of stress that you need to get over, things that you, I feel like there's a lot on your mind. There's a lot on your mind, and you're trying to, like, narrow down these thoughts. You've got the 9, the 8, the 4, the 2. You really want to, there's something that's been on your mind here again with the 2 of Swords. There's something that's been on your mind that you haven't been able to heal. And you're really starting to, like, calm down a little bit and sit down and say, okay, what is universe or, you know, these thoughts trying to tell me? Star card here again. One more for the star. Knight of Pentacles. So I feel like you, again, this could be saying that, you know, you're thinking about something that didn't make much progress. Something that wasn't working. Something that didn't have a lot of progress to it. This King of Swords keeps coming out. Knight of Wands. Could be torn between two people. Air sign, fire sign person. Earth sign person for some of you. I feel like you're wanting some kind of action. You're thinking about either communicating or making a move. Overall energy is 4 of Swords. Why is Scorpio the 4 of Swords in their overall energy for the month of June? Why is Scorpio's energy the 4 of Swords? 5 of Pentacles. So you're resting from a period of struggle, a period of having a rough time, going through rough times. You're trying to recover from that. Another 5 here, right? So now you've got the 4 and the 5 and then judgment. I feel like you made the wrong judgment in a situation. You've been through some struggles, you're trying to recover from it, but you're starting to also realize that you may have made the wrong decision. You made the wrong decision for some of you Scorpios. Or this could be someone, this could be vice versa. Someone made the wrong decision about you, but this is representing your energy. You could be healing after something that somebody did to you. Maybe someone made a judgment call about you. They decided to leave you out in the cold, and now you're trying to heal from that. You could have found out as well that there was some sort of third-party situation, and you're going through like a breakup. And you just want to get out of that energy, but you don't know how. You're not confident about this new beginning or how to have this new beginning. Media environment is the 7 of Pentacles. Why is the 7 of Pentacles here? Justice. So this could be karmic. You could be feeling like you're not getting what you want. Even though the 7 of Pentacles talks about, you know, the fruits of your labor coming in, I feel like the way he's looking at it, it's like he's disappointed. He put a lot of work and effort into this, and it didn't turn out the way he wanted to. This could also be karmic with this Justice card here. One more for 7 of Pentacles. One more for 7 of Pentacles for Scorpio's immediate environment. Queen of Cups. So this is just your energy here, someone you're dealing with, but emotionally you're not satisfied with the way something's coming up or the way something turned out. So you're moving forward. You're moving ahead. You're moving on. Knight of Cups. Yeah, look at you. Moving on, moving quickly. What are you moving towards? What is Scorpio moving towards here? What's this energy? What is Scorpio moving towards? Magician, transformation, new beginnings, a new start. Remember the Magician kept coming out before? Moving towards Gemini, moving towards manifestation. Manifesting something new for yourself. I feel like you're coming out of a period where something, you put a lot of work and effort into it, Scorpio. And you know, I feel like that's what holds you back the most, because you put so much effort, you've built this thing up, and it's not working, but it's also like, you don't want to leave it behind either because you've invested so much into it. But you know deep down inside that you're not happy and it's not going to work. It can't continue to work like this where you're not happy. Everything else around you, you know, from other people from the outside looking in, people probably feel like either you're in the perfect relationship, you have the perfect life, perfect job. But if you're not happy, what's the point? Like, you're not living for other people and you're not, you know, you don't have anyone to impress or make happy but yourself. So if you're not genuinely happy with all that you have, even though people may say you're crazy for wanting to move on and leave, if you're not happy, you're not happy. Period. That's never going to get better. That's not going to change. I feel like you've already put in a lot of effort and it still hasn't changed. You're moving towards manifestation, new beginning. Ha. Yeah, you're moving towards 10, your 10 of pentacles, like I was saying. You're moving towards your 10. You don't want 7. You don't want 8. You don't want 9. You want 10. So like I was saying, you want the best. You want the best. You're not settling for less. You're not going to settle for anything less than the best. And you're out. You're on the mission. You're on the pursuit. Everyone's getting these cards, guys. I promise you. I don't know what's going on. If anybody in the, you know, who's watching this video, if you guys are like into astrology, into, you know, I'm slowly learning myself, but if you guys can let me know why this Ace of Wands and Ace of Pentacles is coming out in every single zodiac sign's reading. If it's not the combination of both, it's at least one of them. Everyone is being reborn. Everyone's having new beginnings. Everyone is starting fresh. I don't know if it's Gemini season that's bringing that about, because Gemini has had like the best reading so far. They are truly being reborn and blessed, but I feel like everyone is starting a new journey right now. All right, so let's see what's going on. So yeah, please put that in the comment section. Let me know if you know. Is it the planets aligned in a certain way? What's going on? Why is all these new beginnings happening for everyone? So let's find out what's going on for Scorpios in their love life. Scorpio, Sun, Moon, and Rising. We'll do one card for singles, one for couples. So what's going on for Scorpios in the month of June 2018, single Scorpios? What's going on for single Scorpios? Okay. Ooh, and then what's going on for Scorpio couples? Scorpio couples in the month of June. Interesting. All right, makes perfect sense. So, single Scorpios, it says express your love. It says go ahead and make the romantic gesture and check you out. Go ahead and do it. You guys are going to do it already. You weren't confident about it before, but you guys are going to do it already. You realize the way you've been going about it is not working, so now you're going to just go ahead and like open up, be honest, express yourself, express how you've been feeling, what you want to manifest with this person. You're going to be more expressive in the month of June. You're going to really deliver that message. For those of you who are in a relationship, it says release your ex. It says the time has come to clear your energy. So for some of you guys, like again with this third party energy here, some of you guys are still in love with your ex. Some of you guys are. Or the person you're dealing with, this could just be saying that, you know, maybe the person you're dealing with is a soon to be ex, right? And it's time to clear that energy here with the Tower card. The Tower is all about like knocking shit down, clearing things out of your way. It's time to release. For some of you guys, it's time to release this person, release your ex if they're getting in your way, for moving forward and having and being happy. But pretty much it's time to release energy, clear energy. Something is causing blockages in your relationship right now. Let's do one more for Scorpios who are not going through that situation, even though I see it here. What else for Scorpios in committed relationships? Forget it. Free yourself. Forget it. Release yourself and free yourself. Yeah, a lot of you Scorpios are not in happy relationships. And they could be happy, but you're just not happy. Like I said, you guys are not happy. Right? I think you guys know what makes you happy. That's why you're going for it. I like it like that. You're like, I don't like this. I know what I like. I'm going for it. I'm going for it. I don't know how. I don't know if it's going to work out. I'm going for it. That's the Scorpio attitude I like. That aggressive, pursuant. Is that a word? Pursuant? Anyway, you know what I mean. You guys, when you guys like something, you pursue it aggressively. All right, so what's some general advice for Scorpios in the month of June 2018? What's some overall general advice? That was quick. Do I even want that? Trust. Yeah, trust. Look how similar these cards are right here. Almost the same exact body language, right? Where she's, you know, she's worried. She's feeling scared. Look at the water rushing up against her and the water here. She feels, in these cards, it both represents feeling like you're in danger, but needing to trust because she can't see where she's going, but there is a way out. She is also scared because of how rough the waters are ahead of her, but she has guidance here with the dove who's telling her to trust, to not fear the choppy waters ahead of her. Really good card, the way that came out. You guys need to trust. Trust the direction that you're being led to. Unconditional love. You guys are moving towards something that you feel you have unconditional love with. This is my favorite card, and also it reminds me of the Lovers Gemini card. Some of you guys are strongly dealing with the Gemini. Have faith. Have faith. I say go for it. I say go for it. If you're going to move towards someone, you're going to try to manifest a new beginning with someone else, you're obviously not happy where you are. Go for it, Scorpio. Do your thing. I'm not even going to read from the book because it's pretty straightforward. Trust it. Trust what's happening right now. You're being divinely guided, I feel. Express your love. Free yourself from things that are not making you happy. And go for what it is that you want. Trust that if you go for it, you will be successful. Great reading, Scorpio. If you guys want to book a private reading with me, all my info is going to be below. It'll have a link to my website. You can purchase the reading there. And I hope you guys have an amazing June. I really, really do. It seems like it's going to be. And I hope you guys get what you want, all right? And just a side note, today is my birthday. So I'm doing readings on my birthday, but I'm happy to do it. I partied all weekend, so I'm happy to spread good messages, good vibes on my birthday. So extra love, extra wishes to you guys, and I'll see you for your mid-month checkups. Bye.